say amen?
Amen.
Amen. The Bible, the Word of God says, He made me to lie down in green pasture. He led me beside the still water. That's all. May the Lord have a blessing to the readers and doers of this holy divine word. Turn to your neighbor and says, neighbor,
neighbor,
God is still holding me.
God is still holding me.
While He's working on me.
While He's working on me.
All right, may be seated. God is holding me while He's working on me. Rather we realize it or not, my beloved, in this life, in this Christian journey, we are all a work in progress.
Amen.
Am I safe to say that? Amen.
Amen.
That we are all a work in progress. Amen. God the Potter, amen. He is still working on us. Amen. In the midst of our enemies. Come on, somebody. Amen. David, amen. David, King David, amen. He writes this in his despairing time. Because if you look at the 22nd novel, he is truly in some hurt, pain. Some things that, you know, me and you, amen, we can relate to, amen. In this life, in this Christian walk, amen. Although we're saved by grace, although we have fresh mercy, amen, we still feel hurt. We still feel pain, amen, that sometimes, amen, if you're not careful, that pain will lead to somewhat of bitterness.
Amen.
And my beloved, amen, we must be mindful in this life, amen, that no matter what we go through, no matter how things may seem or may appear, amen, there's a blessing on the other side of
through.
Amen. There is a blessing on the other side of through, amen. And David, amen, King David, amen, while he was in this despairing moment in his life, amen, he starts off in verse 1. He says, the Lord is my shepherd. See, that was not only for his enemy, that was not only for the people around him, but that he had to remind himself.
Right now.
And I discovered in his life, amen, that sometimes you got to remind yourself who you do belong to. Hello, wife.
Amen.
You go through struggle after struggle, trial and tribulation, and sometimes you have to turn your life aside, turn your face to the wall and say, Lord, here I am.
Amen.
Lord, He is my shepherd. See, I love it how he writes this. He said, he got personal with this. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. I don't know about you, but I can ask for myself. The Lord is my, that is something. I'm holding ownership, amen. He is my shepherd. And I shall not want. And I checked this morning, he said that he maketh me. Lord have mercy.
Thank you.
And what I discovered in this Christian walk, amen, that in this life, amen, sometimes God has to make you. He has to force you. He has to put you in a situation where you ain't got no choice but to lean on him. Lord have mercy. If anybody has been into a situation that you call sister so and so, you call your brother, you call your mama, and it seems that nobody got no money.
Right now.
If you got more love than you got money, you forget to call your shepherd. Lord have mercy. It's important that we remind ourselves who we belong to. Who is our author and the finish of our faith? Who is the one who woke us up this morning? Who is the one, amen, that spoke to win the way? We must remind ourselves.
Okay.
See, it's important, amen. Yes, yes, yes. It is our Christian duty to encourage someone else. But every now and then, you have to encourage yourself. And I feel in my spirit in this day and time, in the season that we're in, amen, that we even need some of the carols. And if I can't encourage myself, who else going to encourage me?
Amen.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, be mindful. Here the text, he says that. He's making me to lie down. And be mindful in the text, it doesn't say lay down. See, when I lay down at night to go to sleep. That's something I choose to do. But the text said he making me to lie down. That's something he's pushing me, he's making me. He said, be still. I remember, amen, just on a couple of yesterday, amen, I could come in, see my son Jojo and my daughter Jada's getting into a counseling. And I said, son, go lay down before I put you down. See, that's why a lot of times we get with God. That God tells us to lay down, and we don't choose to. So God has to force us to lay down, to lie down, amen, to lie down. He says, listen,
Why in the midst? I know about the David, how King David, what he said, he made me to lie down. And understand this, my beloved. I've learned this when I was a young kid. He said, listen, God has the whole world in his hand. He has me and you, baby. Y'all remember that, don't you? See, that's another thing. You're not just laying to lie down anywhere, but you're lying down in the hands of God.
All right.
And it's just like God, in the midst of my go through, in the midst of my struggle, in my defeat, in the midst of my mess up, in the midst of my mistakes, he's yet still molding me and holding me while working on me. Lord have mercy. Y'all ain't here. I said, he's yet holding me while working on me.
Yes.
He said his word. He's holding me while working on me. See, my beloved, he'd be mine, but just like Luke said, he is the great physician, amen. See, God has to take out his scope. He has to take out his life, amen. He has to cut it off and take some things out of us. They don't belong. What I discovered in my short term of living, my beloved, that listen, there is a key difference, a big difference between God's hand being over you and God's hand being in you. Jesus, they won because of we all walking on somebody's prayers.
Yeah.
We all banking on somebody else's prayers. Yeah. That's what that happened. That's why prayer is so in this. Let me put a pin in the pin right there. See, the Bible says, amen, that men should always pray. Because see, in our foolish state, amen, we don't believe, we don't even know how to pray for ourselves.
All right now.
And I thank God that mama had enough sense and loved me so much that she prayed for me.
Yeah.
And when I didn't have enough sense to pray for myself.
Right now.
See, that's God's hand over me.
Oh, yeah.
Because of God's, because mama prayed for you. But now in the season that we're in, the situation that we're in, where demons are coming in by the droves into people, amen. Because God has not that present residence in their heart, amen. Listen, be mindful, either you're gonna be led by the spirit or the devil. There ain't no in between. Let's put that out there. Amen. Let's make that very clear. Amen. Be mindful of the love that, listen, it is God that is allowing us to breathe. It is God allowing us to be here. It is God that allowed you to make it through the ice and storm. It was not love.
Yeah.
I can imagine. I found it mighty disrespectful to myself. If somebody said, you didn't know that's luck and you didn't help them out. No, it was the Lord.
Yeah.
So what do you think about God? Amen. I remember, let me bring it back. Amen. I remember the New Testament. Amen. When one of the prophets, amen, did what the Lord said do. Amen. He got put in prison and it was God that freed him. And the king of that era, he said, no, it wasn't God. Amen. The Bible said that he killed him because he took God's glory. Be mindful, my beloved. It's very careful. Don't ever take God's glory. Don't take credit for the Lord's glory. As we rewind back to the story, we realize about the text, he says, listen, he made me to lie down. Lie down. What am I doing in my lying down state, spirits? Where do I go? Who do I turn to? What the situation? Who can I call on? Well, I'm glad you asked. You answered the questions. You can call on Jesus.
All right.
He is the one who has made you to lie down.
All right.
See, I discovered this. God can't fight our battle unless we lie down. Y'all ain't hearing me. See, my beloved, too many times we're trying to fight our battle. And God said, listen, if you just lie down and let me do my job, your way will be a lot more easy. But just like us in human nature, is the thing that we can do it all by ourselves. Be careful, my beloved, because what happens with us is that we get caught up in our idolatry when we tell God by our actions as well as our vocabulary. Listen, God, I don't need your help on this one. I can do it. Listen, you came to God. God didn't come. God needs you. God don't need you. You need God. So be mindful, amen, when we put ourselves in God's position, we set ourselves up for failure. Yeah. Idolatry is so easy to do, amen. God said, listen, let me handle it. He said, no, I got this one. I think I'm a little bolder right now. I got this one. No, God said, listen, if I saved you once, I can save you again. If I deliver anybody here, saying, if I deliver you once, I can deliver you again. And it's because, amen, the key to success in order to be delivered by God is to be, have a free will that submits to you. Listen, God can't bless you being stubborn. Amen. God cannot use you if you're not flexible. In order to be blessed by God, you got to be obedient to God. As a child of God, amen, we must be mindful of who we really belong to. See, in the text, you said he's making me to lie down. Not in just any pasture, but green pastures. See, God is so graceful and loving, amen. He don't just make us lie down anywhere. He don't make us just lie down, amen. Over there on a bunch of rocks, but he prepares and he made us been working on me and holding me while he's working on me. And I thank God that even though I'm not where I want to be, but I thank God I'm not where I need to be. Y'all miss that. See, I need to be down in the dark. My sin caused me to be killed. But I thank God.
Yes, sir.
He made a way for me. See, my beloved, what I discovered in this thing is that Christianity is a big situation, my God, and God alone. I thank God that my salvation is not based on man, but it was a tree of Calvary. I thank God that it was God, it was Christ, amen, that paved the way, not man paved the way. Y'all ain't hear me, you won't pray with me a little while here in the morning. Amen. And just out there, I don't know, you're looking more, amen. God is telling us, listen, in order for me to take you to the next level, in order for me to bless you, amen, so pastor, you can all have all understanding, you must first lay down for me to serve.
Right now.
Yes, sir.
See, God's hand been over us, caused some things. Good things, but the bad things, amen. It caused, amen, us to be protected from all hurt, harm, and danger. It causes us, amen, to, even though we're at the wrong place at the wrong time, but we don't get be put up there, don't get killed in that wrong place. See, that's God's hand been over you, amen. See, but it also picks up some good, some bad habits along the way. It also picks up some dark in there, amen. It picks up some unchristian-like characteristics, amen. But in the life that we're in this day and time, now God is positioning himself differently into us and saying, listen, now my hand is going from being over you to in
you. Alright.
Yeah, yeah.
And when the hand is in here, it's not comfortable, y'all. Lord have mercy. I don't know about you, amen, but it's his hand. It's not comfortable. It's not supposed to be comfortable because, see, listen, in order for him to get out of us what don't belong in us, he has to snatch out some things.
Yeah.
See, this is not an easy process, amen. Some habits are so hard to break.
Right.
I remember a young lad down mine, my granddaddy smoking cigarettes. I said, granddaddy, why do I smoke cigarettes so much? He said, it's just a habit, a bad habit I picked up. And then, after him going to the emergency room and having his stomach, half his stomach was passing, and I said, granddad, he stopped smoking. I said, granddad, what happened? He said, listen, he said, but I stopped that bad habit. See, we're purpose-driven people. See, he would never stop smoking unless he has, if that surgery would never took place. See, my beloved, let's check this out. Listen, in order to be blessed by God, amen, you have to have a purpose. What is my purpose? I'm trying to be more like him. I'm trying to be blessed by him. I'm trying to have more anointing. But in order for me to have more anointing, I must submit to him.
Amen.
See, my beloved, what I discovered in my short-term living is this, that, listen, God wants to use us, but do you want to be used by him?
Right now.
God wants to use you. But the question is, do you want him to use you? My beloved, God can use whoever he wants to. We learn this throughout the 60 books of the Bible. He found man at his worst and made him his best. That's his characteristic. And for somebody who's dealing with guilt, somebody who's dealing with depression and oppression, listen, God looks for the unjust and classifies them justice.
Yeah, yeah.
Lord have mercy. I said God looks for the unjust. And he, by his blood, he classifies them just.
Yeah.
We were all wretched on God. Listen, my Bible says, listen, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Yeah.
Oh.
Right, right.
All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Even on my best day, I still come short.
Y'all
ain't gonna hear me. I said, even on my best day, I still come up short. But I thank God that he's already made his things fixed. See, my brother, I'm just going with this. Amen. Life is not fair. Amen. We all have had some bad cause dealt to us. Amen. But the beauty of the situation is that, listen, we know that we belong to the dealer. And the dealer knows how, and we'll give us a call when we need it. Y'all don't hear me. I said, listen, in order, amen, to play the hand that you dealt, in order, amen, to be conquered through Christ Jesus, you got to let God lead you how to play your hand. In the text, it says he's making me to lie down. Now, not just any pastor, but green pastors. Then the text goes before the fall. He says, listen, he leading me beside the still water. Now, I believe this in the text. It says that. Now, I never seen the sheep tell the shepherd what to do. Y'all are hearing me. I said, I never seen the sheep tell the shepherd what to do. See, David goes back to memorization, back into his mind when he was a young lad. Tending to the sheep when he was a young shepherd boy, amen. Taking care of the sheep, and he compares this with how he took care of the sheep and how God takes care of his people. And in order for us to understand this, that, listen, the still waters. Now, when I get to study this text, amen, he leading me beside the still waters, amen. Not in the water, but beside the still water. Now, listen, my beloved, in the Hebrew, this break down not to just regular water. See, what you got to be mindful here in our text, in order to enjoy good water, you have to have bad water. Close to home. In order to enjoy a good car, you have to drive a hoopty first. Y'all still ain't gonna pay for me. In order to thank God for power of windows, you have to first roll it up.
Right now.
And you have to take a look before we have that Christian rent and apply and put on the end. They had to close up and you have to roll it up and air line in and get water out and you have to get something from vice grip. You have to pull it. No, y'all ain't gonna pay
for me.
All right then.
We don't enjoy good things until we have to enjoy the bad. We cannot enjoy good shoes when we have some bad shoes.
Right.
Everybody has some bad shoes. So don't make your feet just show no hurt. You see, your feet just be smoking. And soon you get a good pair of shoes on, you don't want to take them off. They so calm, you just want them to go to bed. Because they feel good to your feet. But what are you saying, sir? Listen. This water in the text, he says, and he was looking at the break this thing down, he says, listen, through the, in this water I have before me to enjoy the good things, I have to go through hard times. See, he's leading me through my hard times. He also says about, I have to go through desperate times, amen, where I feel that I'm lonely, I feel like I can't go no more. I feel you're ready to throw in a towel. That's when the Bible says that he is my shepherd.
Yes.
See, you cannot make it through the bad times. You can't make it through the difficult times by yourself. You cannot make it, amen, my beloved. You cannot make it through the hardness and staying firm in the belief without the Lord. Because he is the solid foundation. The foundation is God. Without God, you have no foundation. In this in Texas, amen, my beloved, you cannot build anything on sinking foundations.
Right.
And let's break this thing down here. And I don't claim to know it all, but I know a little bit about some housing things. And what I discovered is this. When in Texas, if you don't water your foundation every now and then, some cracks in that way coming out of that wall. What are you saying? So if in this Christian walk, amen, yes, Christ is our foundation. Yes, we love him. Yes, we know we belong to him. But if you don't do no repair, if you don't study God, if you don't come faithfully to God's house, so Christ is your foundation, will say. When you find yourself doubting God when you used to believe in God, when you find yourself having more misery than you have today, you find yourself saying, listen, I once had that love and drive to come to God's house and to worship him no matter who showed up, because now your foundation is cracked. And when cracked foundation goes on, it has cracks go deeper and longer. And then we find ourselves separated from God. Yes, you can be separated from God's joy in the midst of God's house. You can be separated from God's joy in being in the midst of his house, in the holy of holiness. Listen, my beloved, my angel Satan is very effective what he do. Not giving him no praise and not worshiping him, but I'm respecting what, I'm looking at what he does throughout the 60 books of the Bible in our lives. Listen, he has a nutrition that's effective what he do. So listen, what you're saying, sir, listen, in the midst of my God making me to lie down in the midst of him, putting me on an operating table as people thinking I got it all together and all my bills are paid, and God is yet working on me, don't realize I'm just making it by God's grace and mercy. It was because of God loved me so that I'm yet still before you right now, just because I look like I'm without money, don't mean I got money. Don't ever mistake God's blessing in man's mercy. Don't ever mistake God's favor and man's ambition. Because man's ambition is to have God's favor. But he can't receive God's favor without submitting to God. Oh, Lord, have mercy. I got to get out of here in the morning. Amen. Let me mind you. Look at this text. He said, he leading me beside the still water. As God is leading me through my certain situation, as God is leading me through my trial and tribulation, as God is leading me through my hard times, as God is leading me through my oppression, whether my depression, I'm talking about some real folks in here. Amen. You can't be a Christian and get oppressed. You can't be a Christian and get depressed. Amen. You can come to church and still not have the peace and love that you once had. You can't come to God's house and not feel God's presence. You can, but it is then right now in the text. He said, it is then, it is right where God wants you to be, because now he has caused some things to fall off of you. Lord, have mercy. See, I love how fire does, amen. If anybody, when I had a way of saying it like this, he said, baby, if any was in you, God eventually come out of you. See, my beloved, when God's hand is over us, some things have we picked up that were not belong. Now God's hand is in us, and he's taking out some things that don't belong. He wants to put more in on you, but before he put more in on you, he has to take out more. He got to take out that sin that don't belong. My beloved, we must be mindful here as we in this Christian world that is a blessing to be held by God, to be held by God while he yet is still working on you. It is all of us still a work in progress. I thank God that I'm not where I used to be. I even thank God, I thank that I'm not where I need to be, because he was holding me in a palm of his hand. I still a work in progress. Is anybody here know that you still a work in progress? And God is still working on you. You ought to thank God for that. Because if you look forward in the book of Romans, he said he could have given you up to a reprobate mind. That simply means that God stopped working on them and he let them have what they love to do most. So I thank God that he's still working on me. If anybody here, thank God for him working on you. Is anybody here? Say, well, he's just holding you. I thank him that he thought enough love on me, that he held me and still working on me. He's holding me and working on me. God don't hear me. He held me when the devil came in like a blood, but he put a stand up against me. He's holding me when it's but the Lord made me something. He's holding me when I was getting ready to go in this house. When he kept me to go, a little while longer. He's holding me right now. Get anybody here? Make God a holy. Don't fool me now.
I'm
You may ask, why scrubs? You know it all right, because I'm here today, and in the name of God's house, there's a good day in my book, that I have another chance to give God some praise. Though the church is now open, and maybe one come to the one and only God in a different way. Let's look at Mr. Cotton. I learned how to hold it. I learned
Love Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Whoa.